welcome to the class of editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding Narsimhanomics and the middle way written by Sanjay Bharu. Now this editorial is important from general studies, mains, examination paper 2 point of view, plus important for essay and interview 2. Now this editorial is about the ex prime minister of India, PV Narasimha Rao. This editorial is about the controversy that why a memorial is being established by the BJP government to the BJP party he never belonged to, whether the memorial that is being set up is a kind of an insult to the Congress party, and why the Congress party has never paid the reverence, the respect to our prime minister that was almost second best to Jawaharlal Nehru. Why has Congress never capitalized on the works, not the works, actually the huge works that were done by Narasimha Rao? Now, if we want to understand the personality of Narasimha Rao, if we want to understand the importance of Narasimha Rao to India, and if we want to compare him with the leaders like Jawaharlal Nehru, Indira Gandhi and Rajiv Gandhi, we need to understand of the works that he had done for India. Now Narasimha Rao was a kind of a liberal leader. He was a leader who had a very modernistic vision for India. He was a leader who wanted India to be on the path of real development. It was because of this he had introduced drastic changes in the economic policy of India. From India being following the socialistic India, he was the one to give India complete shift, or you can even call it as a U-turn towards the capitalist ideology. He was the one who had brought in the changes, the westernized changes, and they were embedded in the India's economic functioning. It was him who had brought in the changes in the democracy, the way the democracy was working in India. He has established, he has led to the setting up of the Panchayati Raj system in India. It was because of his firm efforts that the Panchayati Raj institutions, they were given up a constitutional status. It was because of Narasimha Rao that India had been able to tread on the path of nuclear development. It was because of Narasimha Rao the more spending was done in the sectors like education as well as health. It was because of Narasimha Rao that India's relationship was strengthened with the northeast countries. It was because of Narasimha Rao that India began to develop good relationship with the United States of America. It was because of Narasimha Rao that India had been able to weather the collapse of USSR. Now, the question is, when a prime minister belonging to a particular party and who has done so much and so huge for the country is not being revered by that party, what is the reason of neglect? What is the reason of abhorring up such a prime minister? The reason lies in the way the Indian politics is conducted. The reason lies in the fault lines of the voters. The reason lies in the way the elections are conducted in India. The reason lies in how religion is acting as a fodder group for the political parties. Now, as far as Narsimha Rao is concerned, P.V. Narsimha Rao, he was the first Prime Minister, non-congressional Prime Minister, to complete the non-Gandhi Prime Minister who has completed this 5-year tenure. And he was the first Prime Minister to belong to South India. But why is he is not being revered the way he should be revered? It is because the Narsimha Rao had failed in the act to stop the Babri Masjid demolition. Now, it is a fact that he was aware of the Karsevaks who were going on to demolish the Babri Masjid. By doing this, he has kind of helped the BJP party. He has kind of helped the Vishwa Hindu Parishad. He has kind of helped the RSS in their goal to establish Ram Mandir in Ayodhya. Now, the Congress as a political party has always remained a favorite of the Muslims. The Muslims more or less have always remained staunch followers of the Congress party, because this is a party that had projected, that had shown of being their natural guardians. Now, because the Muslims were the fodder group for the Congress, and the Narsimha Rao, being the Congress Prime Minister, had helped or catalyzed, you can say, the demolition of the Babri Masjid, it was hated by the Congress party. So, Congress party ka jo voting share hai, Muslim mein khisak jata, Muslim population se, agar wo Narsimha Rao ko ek bada stature de dete, if they will end up, or if they will provide Narsimha Rao with a stature, then it will be abhorred, it will be hatred by the Muslim sections. Now, this is the equation that is liked by the BJP party. The BJP party, it is built upon only the Muslim vote share. The BJP party don't believe in gathering the votes from the Muslims. The BJP party's agenda, n number of times I've told you, they have based on Hindi, Hindu and Hindustan. It is less about secularism, it is more about enveloping India with a vision of Hinduism. The Hindu way of living, the Hindu way of guiding up one's life. So this is how the BJP behaves, this is how the BJP acts. And now they want to capitalize on P.V. Narsimha Rao, because this is the only Prime Minister that had ever belonged to the Congress but had done something good, or has done something that is not hated or disliked by the BJP party and its ideology. So this was all for this editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is EIAS Mentors. You can contact me at 84594000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes on entire civil services preparation. You can also visit our websites to avail the information. Further information, if you want any on the classes that we are offering, the name of the website is eiasmentors.com and brainyki.com. You can also install our application. Name of the application is Brainyki. You can find this application from Google Play Store. This is for the Android users, and for the Apple users, you can find it at the App Store. And in case you've liked this video, please click on the like button and do comment and share this video. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.